यूनिट वन इंट्रोडक्शन टू सिग्नल्स एंड सिस्टम्स। सो फर्स्ट इज सिस्टम इंट्रोडक्शन। So first is system introduction. A system is defined by a type of input and output it deals with. Since we are dealing with the signals, so in our case, our system would be a mathematical model, a piece of code, a software or a physical device, or a black box whose input is a signal and it performs some processing on that signal and the output is a signal. The input is known as excitation and the output is known as a response. So here the input signal is given to one system and output of this is output signal, which are in different format. Now a system is a term which is used to denote an entity that processes or operates on a signal to another. A system is a term used to denote an entity that processes or operates on signals to transform one signal to another, manipulate, change, record, transmit. A system has inputs and outputs. For example, amplifiers, radios, television, telephone, modem, oscilloscope, ECG, EEG, EMG, these all are the systems. So in this figure, the system has been shown whose input and output both are the signals, but the input is analog signal and the output is called as a digital signal. It means our system is actually the conversion system which convert analog signal to digital signal. Now conversion of analog to digital signal means, since there are lot of concepts which is related to this analog to digital conversion and vice versa, we will see only the concept which is related to digital processing. So there are two types, that is sampling and quantization. Now we will see in short what is sampling. It is a process which suggests it can be defined as taking a sample. So take a sample of digital signal over a x-axis and sampling is done on an independent variable. And quantization means, it means it suggests, it can be defined as dividing into the quanta, that is a partition, and quantization is done on dependent variable, so it is opposite to sampling. So this is in short what is conversion. So system is an arrangement of physical components which are connected in such a manner to our desired objective. Electrical system as an electric system, the resistor, inductor, capacitor, transistor and so forth that make up the circuit are the system components. A system is a two-port network. One port is called input port and other is output port. So if an excitation or input signal is applied to the input terminal, a unique response or the output signal will be measurable or observable at the output terminal. A system that transforms a signal from one form to another form is called transducer. The relationship between the input, that is excitation, cause the signal and the output, that is a response. Output means response, which is effect. Signal is essential in defining a classification of the system. So there are lots of examples of the system. First is, in an automatic speaker recognition system, the input signal is speech or voice signal. The system is computer and the output signal is identify of the speaker. Then in communication system, the input signal could be a speech signal or the computer data, and the system itself is made up of the combination of transmitter, a channel and the receiver, and the output signal is an estimate of original message signal. In an aircraft landing system, the input signal is the desired position of the aircraft relative to the runway. The system is aircraft and the output signal is the correlation to the lateral position of the aircraft. So system can be classified as a system type. So depending on the system type, it can be classified as electrical system, electronic system, mechanical system, thermal system. So we will see this classification later on. Before that, we will see the representation of the system. Now, how do you represent a system mathematically? Since a system transforms a signal into another, we can write yt is equal to x of t, where this t is an operator to symbolize the system. So x of t is the signal that goes into the system, that is the input, and y of t is the transformed signal or the output signal. So we can represent this by using this diagram. Now, examples of continuous time system. A square system, yt is equal to x of t square. The output equals the square of the input, and this is the result of putting the sine wave into a squarer. So this is an example of continuous time system. Now we might be able to build this using an electronic system. Now this type of the system whose input and output both are continuous signals or the analog signals are called continuous signal. What is continuous signal? What is continuous system? In continuous system, both the input signal and the output signal are continuous signal or the analog signal. While discrete time system, if we put a discrete time signal into our system, then output may be a discrete time level. Discrete time signal. This is called discrete time system. That means here the input and output both are discrete. So using the square example, y and in discrete, the t will be t is replaced by n. So yn is equal to x of n square. The graph for this is shown here. The type of the system whose input and output both are discrete signal or the digital signal, these systems are called as digital systems. The systems are classified into following categories. So before this classification, we will see the system can be classified as depending on the system type, system category, system operation, system character, parameters, behavior, number of variables, system signal characteristic, problem to be solved, computer in control. So depending on the system type, it is classified as electrical, electronic, mechanical, thermal, hydraulic, chemical, bioengineering and others. Depending on the system categories, it can be classified as open loop and closed loop system. Depending on the system operation, it is continuous data or discrete data. Depending on the system character, system can be classified as linear, non-linear, casual, non-casual, static and dynamic. The parameters behavior in time. Depending on this parameter behavior, it can be a time invariant, time varying. Time varying means parameters are the function of time, that it changes with time. Depending on the number of variables or the number of signals, it can be classified as signal. It can be classified as SISO, that is single input, single output, or MIMO, that is multiple input, multiple output. The systems, depending on system signal characteristic, it can be classified as deterministic, random, or random. depending on the problem to be solved, the system can be classified as software or hardware. Depending on the computer in control, it can be offline, that is computer outside control loop, or it can be online, that is computer inside control loop. So first we will see the linear and non-linear system. So first is linear and non-linear system. Now system is said to be linear when it satisfies the superposition and homogeneous principle. Now consider the two systems with the input x1 of t and x2 of t, and outputs of this is y1 of t and y2 of t respectively. Then according to superposition and homogeneous principle, the t of a1 into x1 of t plus a2 into x of t is equal to a1 into t into x1 of t plus a2 into t into x2 of t. So t of a1 x1 t plus a2 x2 t is equal to a1 y1 t plus a2 y2 t. So from this expression it is clear that the response of overall system is equal to the response of individual system. Now example, t is equal to x square of t. So y1 of t is equal to t of x1 of t, which is equal to x1 square of t, and y2 equal to t of x2 t is equal to x2 square of t. So t in bracket a1 x1 t plus a2 x2 t is equal to a1 x1 t plus a2 x2 t square, which is not equal to a1 y1 t plus a2 y2 t. So the system is said to be non-linear. That is, here the system is linear if property of superposition holds. Now what is superposition property? Suppose x of t is the input signal of the system and y t is output, and if the input signal is a1 x1 t, then output is a1 y1 t, and a2 x2 t is another input signal, then another output signal is a2 y2 t. Then the superposition property holds if input a1 x1 plus a2 x2, then output a1 y1 plus a2 y2 for linear system. Next is time variant and time invariant system. So, a system is said to be time variant if its input and output characteristic vary with time. Otherwise, the system is considered as the time invariant. If input and output characteristic vary with time, then system is time variant. And if the system is considered as, otherwise system is time invariant. The condition for time invariant system is y of n comma t is equal to y of n minus t. The condition for time variant system is y of n t is not equal to y of n minus t, where y of n comma t is equal to t of x of n minus t, which is input change, and y of n minus t is output change. Now this is the example, y n is equal to x of minus n, then y of n t is t of x of n minus t, that is x of minus n minus t, and y of n minus t is x of minus of n minus t, which is equal to x of minus n plus t, where y of n t is not equal to y of n minus t. So the system is time variant. If the characteristic or the properties of the system do not change with time, then the system is called time invariant system. Otherwise, system is time varying. For time invariant system, now consider yt is equal to sine of ut. If u of 0 is 1, then y of 0 is sine 1. Now the system is time invariant because the input the output is always sine 1 and no matter what t is. If system is given by yt is equal to sine of t u of t, then when u of t is equal to 1 at time t is equal to 0, the output y0 is equal to sine 0 x1 which is equal to 0. If the same input is applied at t equal to 1, then y1 is equal to sine 1 into 1 which is equal to 0.84 into 1, that is 0.84. So the system is described by yt equal to sine of t ut is time varying system. Thus the time invariant system is given by yt is equal to a into u of t, where a is constant, and time varying system is given by at ut, where at is time varying. Next is linear time variant and linear time invariant system. Its system, if the system is both linear and time invariant, then it is called linear time invariant, and if the system is both linear and time invariant, then it is called as linear time invariant system. Now when system is linear, when the system is said to be linear if it satisfies the superposition principle, then system is called as linear system. And when system is called as time variant or invariant, if the time shifts in the input signal results in corresponding time shift in both output, then the system is called as invariant system. Next is static and dynamic system. Next is static and dynamic system. Now, a static system is memory-less, whereas dynamic system is memory system. For example, 1, yt is equal to 2x of t. For present value t equal to 0, the system output is y0 is equal to 2x of 0. Here, output is only dependent upon a present input, hence the system is memory-less or static. Now, example 2 is yt equal to 2x of t plus 3x of t minus 3. For present value t equal to 0, the system output is y0 is equal to 2x0 plus 3x of minus 3. Here x of minus 3 is past value for the present input, for which the system requires memory to get this output. Hence, the system is a dynamic system. Now, a static system is a system in which output at any instant of the time depends on the input sample at the same time. In other words, the system in which output depends only on the present input at any instant of the time, then system is called static system. Static system is memory-less system. Dynamic system is a system in which output at any instant of the time depends on the input sample at the same time as well as at other times. In other words, the system is the system in which output depends on the past and or future input at any instant of time, then this system is known as the dynamic system. A dynamic system possesses memory. So consider x of t is the input and y of t is the output of the system. Then yt is equal to 2x of t. Now substitute t equal to 0, then y0 equal to 2x of 0. And if yt equal to 1, then y1 is equal to 2x of 1. So in this example, the output y of t at t instant depends on the input x of t at the same time instant. So this system is static system. Now, second example is yt is equal to x square t. If we substitute t equal to 0, then y0 is equal to x of 0. If we substitute t equal to 1, then y1 equal to x square of 1. Then output y of t at instant t, here also instant depends on the input x of t at the same time instant t. So this system is static system. So a system is called static if output of system is dependent on the present value of the input, and a system is called dynamic if the output of the system depends on the past or the future values of the input at any instant of time. Next is casual and non-casual system. Now, system is said to be causal if output depends upon a present and past input and it does not depend upon the future input. For non-causal system, the output depends upon a future input also. For example, yn is equal to 2x of t plus 3x of t minus 3. Then for present value at t equal to 1, the system output is y1 equal to 2x1 plus 3x of minus 2. Now here the system output depends upon the present and past input, so the system is causal. Now second example is yn equal to 2x of t plus 3x of t minus 3 plus 6x of t plus 3. Now here for present value t equal to 1, the system output is y1 equal to 2x1 plus 3x of minus 2 plus 6x of 4. So the system output depends upon the future input. So the system is called non-causal system. So a system is said to be a causal system if the output depends on the present and past input only and not on the future. And a system is non-causal if the output at any time depend on the values of the input from the future. That is, non-causal system does anticipate the future values. So, causal system means physical, that is non-anticipatory system. A system is causal if its present response or the output to an input signal does not depend on future values of that input. That is, y t equal to 0 for t less than 0. This means that the output of causal system at given time depends on the present and past input signal. That is yt equal to f of x of 1 minus lambda into x of t. Now remember that the future values of the input signal is x of 1 plus y and the past values of the input signal is x of 1 t minus lambda. X of t plus lambda plus x of into x of t minus lambda. If the system does not satisfy the conditions, then the system is non-causal, that is, the non-causal system is anticipatory or non-physical system. This means that the output or the response of non-causal system depends on the future values of the input signal. So yt equal to f of x of t plus lambda at the present time. If system impulse response is h of t, then for causal system ht equal to 0 for t less than 0 and non-causal system ht equal to 0 for t less than 0. Next is invertible and non-invertible system. Now system is said to be invertible if the input of the system appears at the output. So x of t is given to H1 of t and H2 of t is invertible system. So yt is equal to, again that is output is equal to input, so yt equal to x of t. Now ys equal to xs, x of s, h1s, h2s, which is equal to x of s into h1s into h1s into h1 of s, since h2s is equal to 1 by h1 of s. So ys is equal to xs or yt equal to x of t. So the system is invertible. If y of t is not equal to x of t, then the system is said to be non-invertible. Now, suppose x of t and y of t be the input and output of the output signals respectively of the any system, then transformation of x of t into y t is represented by y t equal to t of x of t. Now, what is t? It is the operator which defines the rule by which x of t is transformed into y of t. Now, invertible system, a system is called invertible if there should be 1-to-1 mapping between input and output at particular instant, and when an invertible system cascaded with its inverse system, then the gain of will be equal to the 1. In other words, if the input can be recovered from the system output, then the system is said to be invertible. So mathematically, if we can write yt equal to t of x of t, and z of t signal can be written as zt is equal to t inverse of y of t. Now yt equal to what? It is t into x of t. So t inverse and t get cancelled, and zt equal to x of t. Now a system is called non-invertible if there should be many to one mapping between input and output at a particular instant. Next is stable and unstable system. The system is said to be stable only when the output is bounded for the bounded input. For bounded input, if the output is unbounded in the system, then it is said to be unstable. Now note that for bounded signal, the amplitude is finite. So for example, yt is equal to x square of t. Consider, let the input is u of t, that is unit step bounded input, then the output yt is equal to u2 of t equal to u of 1, that is bounded output. So the system is stable. Now yt equal to integration of x of t dt. Now consider, let the input is ut, that it is unit step bounded input, then output yt is integration of u of t dt, that is ramp signal, that is unbounded because amplitude of the ramp is not finite as it goes to the infinite when t tends to infinity. So the system is unstable. Now, so the basic properties of the systems are memoryless, invertibility, causality, stability, linearity, time invariance. Now what is memoryless? A system is said to be memoryless if its output at given time is dependent only on the input at the same time, that is yt at the time t depends only on x of t at time t, and yn at time n depends only on x of n at time n. A memoryless system does not have a memory to store any input values, but it just operates on the current input. If system is not memoryless, then we can call it a system with memory. A system is invertible if distinct inputs lead to distinct output, or if an inverse system exists. A system is linear if it obeys the principle of superposition. A system is time invariant if a time shift of the input causes the corresponding shift in the output. A system is casual if the output yt or yn at time t or n depends on the input xt of x of n up to the time t or n. In casual system, output does not depend on future input. On the other hand, in non-casual system, the output depends on the future input. A system is stable if every bounded input, that is xt or xn, produces a bounded output, that is yt or yn, for all time t or n. If bounded input produces unbounded output, then the system is unstable. Now, convolution is used to describe the relationship between the input output and the impulse response of LTI, that is linear time invariant system in time domain. So for continuous time system, the impulse response is also a continuous time signal, and for discrete time system, the impulse response is also a discrete time signal. So, this is all about the system classification and introduction to the system and and the first unit, that is introduction to signals and system, is over here. Now from the second lecture, from the next lecture, we will start the second unit. Thank you.